Hello everyone, it's me against the 99k No Brainer, and welcome to the Star Wars Destiny video. Hey Samurai Mac, how's it going?
Going pretty good.
Alright, nice. Well, it's not going great, we're both 1-1 now, right?
True.
You got a Maul Trooper. Alright, I know Maul Trooper. I haven't been playing Covert Missions much, but I know Maul Trooper. That's a very normal deck, right?
Yeah, I guess it's pretty.
Can even do a no good to me Death Star, that's pretty awesome. Well, it's RNG, right? Do I win or do I lose? Who knows? We'll find out based purely on those more rolls. It's a nice R2, though. Nice R2 roll.
Yeah, I actually got it from a block.
Alright. I'm just going to keep pressing the R button until you're ready. Do-do-do. Alright. Okay, I would like to roll that for real. That's a pretty decent roll.
Okay.
6, 4. Okay. So, do I want to kill the trooper or the mole? Probably the mole. We'll go with mine. Although no good to me dead with the shields. Alright, good luck, have fun. We'll start with the enticing reward, which I get for free, hooray. Actually, I think I'll fight on the trooper.
Right. I'm going to...
So I'm putting it on the trooper. Trooper has 7 health, the mole's 15, so you know. It's pretty significant difference there. And Maul actually has shields now, and I want to do damage as quickly as possible for no good to me dead. So that's the idea behind that one. Do I want to play the Boba Fett's Thrust Laser? I don't think I do, really. It's not that good of a card. It's mostly because it's got ambush. It's at best, like, it's some decent damage, but I can't really afford it very well, so. Alright, and that's my roll. That's amazing, right there. One ranged, alright. Need that no good to me dead going.
Saber and do one on Bubba.
Alright. Sentinel Messenger, roll out. Let's see what I get off the top. Alright, gonna keep that on top.
Second, the 2 melee.
I'll shoot the trooper for one. Well, no good to me dead for a pulse cannon, even though I don't have money for it. He's gonna put a target on his back. This has just got really, really awkward. I think I discard the wrist laser, go for some more damage. Alright, there we go, that's some damage.
I'll hit him out of that melee.
Alright, I'm surprised you didn't call range instead. I will shoot the
trooper. Yeah, I didn't pay attention to the eyesight. Okay, I'll overwrite this for Maul's lightsaber.
Ew. No good to me dead, the trooper for 2.
Okay.
Alright, now I have money for pulse scan stuff.
Use the Parashamal Saber
Troll. I will play a pulse can. Casual pulse cannon. Don't worry about it.
I'll use multi power action.
Yep. See how this goes. Ah!
I'll discard.
No!
Hold on. Boba and...
Ow! I pass.
I'll roll in more.
That's an evil start you have. Alright, I will roll in the Sentinel. And off the top is a hidden motive called melee. Okay. The weird way of rolling, but sure.
Yeah.
Legit.
Okay. I'll get a resource again.
I will power action. I will shoot the mole for two. And then I can't afford it.
Okay. I will claim.
Take a resource, do three more to mole. That is my all. Alright, so that's the other pulse cannon, so, and with this dead or alive, I could potentially do some sort of...
I'll pay one for tactical mastery.
Oh dear, he's gonna kill off the sentinel with the, who has the pulse cannon, and then this is game, right? That plus four... doesn't kill it. Just yet.
I'll do three on Bubba.
Alright. I'll dead or alive this First Order Stormtrooper then.
Okay, I will.
I just got two dice that have power action. Pretty good chance to kill Boba here. There's a plus four. I lose, basically. Okay, plus three does kill Boba.
So three on Boba and.
Alright. Sad boys. Sentinel roll. And on the top, reap. Perfect. Alright, that'll give the resource. Man. Then I will do the power action. We will. Yeah. We'll shoot the Stormtrooper for three. It's awkward. And then we'll shoot him for two. And then I can't resolve it.
Yeah. I will use Sayer's power action to roll in.
Mm-hmm. I'll take the resource. Alright, so the idea here is that maybe I can use this talent specific to get Pulse Cannon over.
Discard to roll.
Two melee. We're gonna hit a mode of that two melee. Cool melee. Alright, so he's got this. So he needs one damage, so he's got a 4 and 6 chance on this reroll. Doesn't get it, I can discard this pulse cannon. I can to reroll. Then I can get it back from a tireless pursuit. Get a resource off the dead or alive. Which has not given me a resource in the end. Although if Trooper rolled out,
Trooper.
All right, I get running from dead or alive. I'll discard to reroll. Ugh. Being a little greedy, giving him this extra resource. My hope is that I can kind of just pulse cannon this mole down. That's the one melee he needed. Alright. Tireless Pursuit. Move one damage over to the Stormtrooper. Stormtrooper dies. Enticing Reward goes off. Gives me a pulse count to the Sentinel Messenger. And I get a resource off dead or alive. With the ambush action, I will roll in my Sentinel Messenger. Off the top, ambush free fall. Let's just remove the die. Then I shall power action this other pulse cannon. One disrupt. One for one disrupt. And three for one damage. Alright, at least I got some damage out of that. Eesh.
Yeah,
that was pretty lucky getting that free fall.
I guess I
had chances for Forsakens and stuff, but still, I didn't have that high of a chance. Alright, well, two melee. And then I'll discard to reroll, see if I get some damage out of this. Nope. Alright, these really love to give me some disrupts right now. Yeah, you thought you was all about luck. Does get to go in first. I kind of need an ambush off the top here, which is not very likely. I've already used quite a few.
I will.
One, two, three, and then fourth in my hand. So I've used most of them. Well, you got like three left. But if he hits a not damage off this, all right, then I've got a decent. Then I've got a chance potentially. Can't forsaken it obviously because it's two or less only. All right, I will rot the Sentinel Messenger. Top, keep it on top. Gotta love those disrupts.
Okay, I'll use the power action.
Wow, okay. Well, so really one no good to me dead. I think I just have to go for this pulse cannon and just hope it doesn't have any removal. Alright, we're gonna roll in the Sentinel Messenger. And we're gonna leave what's on the top on the top. Oh my god, disrupts, disrupts, disrupts.
I'll hit him with that to range.
You doubt my disrupt abilities?
Oh my goodness.
I will focus to the 3-for-1. You doubted my disrupt abilities.
Yeah. Okay, I'll roll in.
Think I would roll well. Ha, what a mistake. Okay, yeah, we're gonna forsaken that too. I don't quite die just yet. It's getting close.
Right, I'm going to...
He clearly doesn't have more removal. There's a chance this pulse cannon just kills, but I need to not roll disrupts.
Yeah, I guess I'll use face the enemy.
Oh wow. Alright. Whoops. Alright, which of these six cards do you want to put back on top? If he was just going to resolve, this doesn't get him much. But now he knows that he can go for it. Because I will have no removal. Mitigation. Yeah, no mitigation.
I guess. Yeah.
All right. Now here's my next question: which order do you put them on?
I don't care. You can put however, I guess.
Okay, because if you'd have put it on in the other order, then I had a 100% chance of hitting Reap on my next turn when I rolled out Sentinel Messenger, which would have been an ambush action for Pulse Cannon.
Yeah.
Alright, Pulse Cannon, let's go. So, 3-for-1. 3-for-1, game.
Good game.
Woohoo!
It's down to...
Pulse Cannons?
Yeah.
I mean, you got the +4 off the Maul Saber, but, yeah. Pulse Cannons, Pulse Cannons, Pulse Cannons.
Yeah,
I'm really still not sure if I should have gone for that Stormtrooper in the end, because that was 7 damage that could have been on, Maul. But he got me the Pulse Cannon.
Mm-hmm.
Would have done more than 7, except it kept rolling Disrupt. I will say I did get a little bit lucky with the ambush action for free fall. Off the top. That was nice.
Yeah, that was a really, really strong move there.
Yeah, that was a good turn. Alright, well.
So, do you have a YouTube channel?
Yes. My YouTube channel is No Brainer. That's N-double-O Brainer. I haven't posted anything, I think, since December. But, you know, I used to post TTS content very regularly. It's just one of those things where you get into an awkward rut where I didn't want to release my videos straight away after... I had a bunch of January videos, but I didn't want to release them because the game said it got cancelled, and that put me into a bit of a depression, and then the... And then it was like, well, now my videos just, they're not even good videos. They're just okay. I don't really want to go back to those. And then once you get out of the habit of doing YouTube videos, you really get out of the habit of doing YouTube videos.
Right.
But hey, maybe I'm back this time. We'll see. If there's more Artificer events, I'll go to them. Yeah, I hope you had fun and you keep up with this, because it might end up being that TGS is the only real way we played Star Wars Destiny anymore.
Yeah, well, good luck on the rest of the turn.
And same to you. I mean, you still can make it in. It's 4-2 is the top cut, and you're now 1-2, so. Just gotta win 3 games in a row with them all. No biggie.
Yeah.
Alright. It's been me, Gamesline99, aka No Brainer. Thanks for watching. Signing out.